pretty excited to show you guys one of the oldest dojos in Fukuoka. This one is not a jiu-jitsu school, but it is a judo school. Of course, judo is way more popular than jiu-jitsu in Japan, and there's a lot of fantastic teachers. This is a place I haven't been before, so I'm excited to go there. I won't be training tonight. I trained for 3 hours last night, 3.5 hours last night, and my back is feeling it today, and I'm gonna be traveling a lot and training a lot more this month, so I need to be a little bit careful about that. But anyway, I hope to get you guys some good footage, so let's go to the dojo. This dojo?
Yeah, it's a very old dojo, famous in Japan, almost maybe one of the oldest dojo, about 350 years old. It's famous for one like competition. His name is Seibondori, and some guys in the middle of the tatami must fight with almost 1,000 guys, but must be like 1,000 ippon. So this dojo is very famous for this. Plus have a good collaboration with some judo dojo in New York, and friendly dojo with the people came here. They can live in, upstairs, it's 7 rooms, can play judo, can also sleep here like ryokan. And most of them famous long time ago, sensei Tachi, they have maybe 7, 8, 6 dan. So all of them from Kodokan.
You've been training judo and BJJ in Japan. What are the differences in training those two arts in Japan?
In judo, they are focusing the takedowns, and really they don't play too much in the newaza in the ground. Jiu-jitsu is like judo. They are mostly the same, but more complicated, more look like simple, but it's not simple. But judo guys, they are very strong in the stand-up, tachiwaza. If judo guys start practice jujitsu, I'm 100% they become stronger and more good than only judo. So I think this is good combination between Brazilian jujitsu and judo. Of course, also wrestling and Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu, but judo, and because it's the same gi, it's a very good combination. My advice is who's playing judo also must play some Brazilian jiu-jitsu, because the Minewaza become better and better. So this is my advice. I train also jiu-jitsu, I train also with you many times, but like you see the competition, mostly 80% in a dojo, in the jiu-jitsu, we start for the ground sitting. But all the competition start like judo, in standing. So mostly of them, they go the pull guard faster. But if you also train judo, you can do good takedown. So this is good idea. That's why I train also. The first I start judo 12 years ago, and after jiu-jitsu, almost 10 years.
あと2人で柔道試合も相手がおらんとできないからですね、相手が怪我戦に投げたり、そういうのはやっぱ大体柔道ですね。
Just wanted to let you know real quick, at this dojo they teach not only judo but also a traditional Japanese jiu-jitsu style called Sosuishi Ryu, and if I get a chance to come back, I definitely want to watch them practicing this traditional jiu-jitsu style. That's a lot of the mementos and pictures that you saw at the front of the dojo. That all represents the traditional Japanese jiu-jitsu style. Tonight, they were just practicing judo. But one other very unique thing, which you might have missed in the interview, is the practice of senbon-dori. What that means is scoring 1,000 ippons. So that is something that's done nowhere else at any other dojo in Japan. And of course, they don't have 1,000 different opponents. That would be it'd be hard to scramble up that many people, but there's at least 50 different opponents, and you have to throw them all 1,000 times. So somebody's keeping score, and after you get 1,000 ippons, it's over. That can take a long time. It can take 8 hours or more. And that tradition started about 150 years ago. Over 150 years, 352 people have successfully completed that. Once you have successfully completed 1,000 ippons, your name is permanently recorded on a wooden nameplate in the dojo. Sometimes people have to stop, and they're only given water breaks, I think once every hour, I was told. Also, some people have to go to the hospital, you know, due to dehydration or whatever. They will stop, allow them to go to the hospital, then they'll come back and continue it. It's a pretty rigorous tradition. I was also told that one guy who successfully finished it had to stay in bed for a week, and whenever he would eat something, he would throw it up. So it's definitely not for the faint of heart, but it's a pretty interesting practice that's only done at this dojo. All right, guys, that's it for this time. Thanks for watching. Thanks for leaving your comments, and I'll see you next time.